How do I do the arrow barrage? I found out how to do it. It's Q. Welcome, hunters. My name is Dark Godzilla, and we're back in Bastion. I don't really remember where I left off, to be honest.
That note cuts straight to the heart of things, don't it?
Sure. I don't even know what the note was. Ceramic.
Finding gourmet ingredients ain't easy these days, but we'll take what we can get.
I don't remember.
The note says it plain. Zia, go east to learn the truth about the calamity and our people. I'll be waiting. Sincerely, Zulf.
Yeah, I still don't remember.
Zulf's messenger was one of his people. Wonder just how many of them survived. And what exactly Zulf told them.
Okay, let's, damn it. Take it.
It ain't too late to unlock the potential of this place.
Okay. Let's do... I don't know. Let's do this one. I don't even remember what it is, but I don't care.
The memorial may be finished, but our part is far from over.
Let's go into this guy. You shush. So, no. How? What is this? Okay. Where did I go here? I think those are just, like, maps I can go to, but I have to do more of the shards, maybe. Or they're cleared. I am horribly wrong. Yep, I was horribly wrong. Alright, we're going here.
Not everything blew up in the calamity.
What is a calamity?
Colford Cauldron here blew up way ahead of its time.
What's this? Nothing. I still want to know what the calamity was.
The cauldron boiled over some 300 years ago.
Okay.
They say it filled the skies with ash and the lakes with molten rock.
Smack. Smack.
If you wanted to survive something like that, you had to learn to adapt.
Yeah, I wasn't really paying attention.
Best to keep out of the cauldron.
To anything. What is hitting me? Oh, it's that thing. Okay. I don't even know what that thing was. It was just weird. Yeah, I can't get to it, so never mind. Ah, oh, goddammit. No, these stupid things.
So, in a way, the beasts of the wilds, they're all survivors, too.
Get out of the... No, forget. I missed. I still missed. Oh god, kill it. Kill it. Well, bicycle.
It takes a certain stubborn pride to keep on living in a place like this. As for us, we learn
what is alive.
Colfer Cauldron.
I don't want that weapon, but then give it to me.
That learning led to some interesting inventions.
Burn!
The raw power
burn up
fell right into our hands.
Oh, it's after heal. I have a flamethrower. Burn. Burn, baby, burn. Why the music became intense a little bit? Ow, you stupid. Whoa, no. Oh god. Oh my god.
Can't fault our people for their natural curiosity now, can
you? Okay, I am stuck. I was stuck. What the hell? Where am I supposed to go? I didn't mean to actually press that at all. I am fully not sure what I'm supposed to do. Oh, god damn it, that did take away my hammer. Where? Okay.
Playing with the cauldron's fires became an addiction.
I just went the complete wrong way. Screw you, bird guy. Nope.
Sure, we dusted off a good many secrets out here.
Yep. Bad bird. Bad bird. Bad bird. Bird.
But we discovered other things we're better off not knowing.
Burn! Burn!
The unforgiven scent of sulfurous dirt.
How do I do the arrow barrage? I found out how to do it. It's Q. Burn, baby, burn.
It takes the air so hot it sticks to your lungs.
Okay. Man, I have, like, no health. I don't know what killed me, pretty much. And fire. Stop hurting me! Got it! Yeah. Hi, Bones. You are a dick.
All sorts of awful things crawling underfoot.
You are seriously a dick. No. The heck is that?
Never thought we'd find so much life in all that ash.
I don't know what the pecker's nest thing is. Obviously it's a nest though, but besides that. Burn it all! No, bad bird. Bye, bird. Give me the health.
Something? We kept on sifting through the cauldron's secrets anyway.
Just break, skeleton. Jeez, what is with this skeleton? Why will it not just disappear? Jeez. There's still like a... There we go. God. Nah, forget it. I'll just stick with the fire.
The more ash we swept aside, the more life we found.
Phew! Like me sneezing. Yep.
The place is inhospitable as they come.
It trapped me! Oh, screw you, bird.
But still, we pressed on.
Who is this we? I'm by myself here. You decided to stay at the Bastion. Phew! God damn, made me sneezing. Burn! Holy crap, this is very good against plants. Wow, that is really good against plants.
After all, when we look down inside Colford Cauldron.
Beep. Yes.
Look down through all the smoke and flames.
I'm still waiting for the answer.
We saw in there the heart of the world. The heart now laid bare by the calamity.
The stone?
We had to have it.
Alright.
As for the kid, he just has to get that shard out of there. Too bad taking that thing woke up every last stink eye from here to Jawson Bog.
I was waiting for these stupid... Screw it. Yes! Get together! Come on, group up. Stupid things.
Kid's thinking he's got to trek all the way back around the cauldron.
Do I not have to?
Luckily, the cauldron cooked up a little shortcut for him.
Thank you, cauldron. I always knew I liked
sure
you.
Sure, it ain't the most convenient path.
Shit. Bird! 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 You guys play Portal 2? You know what I'm talking about. God damn you, bird! Jeez! Didn't think you were that annoying. Oh.
Biggest stink guy he's ever seen's waiting for him on the other side. Well, it ain't polite to stare.
But it is polite to kill them. Oh well.
Where there's one stink eye, there's always more.
Sadly. Flamethrower is actually pretty useful. What?
The cauldron's tenants all gather up to bid the kid a fond farewell.
Oh, god damn it.
Kid don't shed any tears for him, though.
Absolutely none. Oh, shit. These things are better off dead. No, just stay there. Am I supposed to go up or down? Down.
With a good spyglass, you can still see the cauldron from the city.
All right.
All the fires died out. There's nothing left of it.
Okay.
It comes back looking like the inside of a chimney.
I don't look like much of a chimney, to be honest, but alright.
The shard works like a charm. You can hear the monument's heartbeat again.
Can you? Can you really?
Oh, what's... Kid arrives just in time to sample Zia's famous cooking.
Okay.
The arsenal's complete, in case we need protection.
But what was new in the... Oh, it's just a fire bellow.
Bow and bellows make a strange and fearsome team. He wolfs down too much too fast, and it all goes to his head.
Alright. Not what I was expecting to happen.
I've said a lot about the kid, but he ain't the only one wrapped up in all this.
Oh, I'm in Bumba Nowhere. What the heck? What the heck was that?
What's he thinking? Well, let me see if I got this straight. I only heard it once.
I'm thinking what the heck is going on? That's what I'm thinking. Oh. Alright, that was stupid. I don't know what...
Once there was a normal Ura girl, but she wasn't born in the Tazzle terminals like the rest of her people. She was from Ceylandia.
God damn it, it's another reflection thing. Well...
Folks were orphaned in the war, taken in and raised inside the city, on condition they would never return to the terminals.
Screw you, birds! Bad bird. Bad.
Ura refugees who came into the city had to stay for life. It was a way to reduce the risk of city secrets leaking out.
Dude. Oh, shit. My favorite freaking plants. My favorite plants. Nope. God damn. I hate those stupid things.
The mama passed away from birthing complications, leaving the girl trapped inside that city with no one but her father.
And her father was a dick. Get away from me. Just die. Just die. Die. Well. No. Bad. Bad.
Her father was sharper than a brusher's pike, so he got a job working for the city's mancers. His daughter barely saw him.
Oh, God. This damn dick. Just keep being shot in the back. Oh, I completely forgot how to dodge roll. Come on. Just keep getting hit. Just keep getting hit. Come on. Not the best for me. God, I hate these things. Just keep being shot in the back, please. Just die. Die, never come back. Don't come back to me. Oh my God, I'm gonna die from this. Cause I hate the stupid frog.
Lost my train of thought there.
Fuck that frog.
Her father told her nothing of her Ura heritage. He told her nothing of the Mancers. It's for your own good, he said. She took to studying the arts, learned more through music than history books, gained a knack for strings and songs.
Die.
At first, she tried to be like other girls, but her classmates spread word that her father was an Ura traitor, selling out the city.
Goodbye, plant. Goodbye. Oh, God. And I just... dodge. Miss me. And I got you. I got you. And it's
dead. One young man stood up for her, or so he led her to believe. He knew much of her heritage, and she grew fond of him.
Okay. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. I completely missed. Burn! I missed. Shit. Burn! 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 Oh, shit, you're faster now. You're so much faster now. You are so much faster now. just need to die. Oh shit.
The young man convinced her to take him to a family den to meet her father. Spoke of how he wanted to meet a man from the terminals.
How's this gonna work out in the story? Burn! Burn the burbs! Nope, bad.
When the young man greeted her father in the Ura's native language, her father flew into a fit of rage and threw them out.
Threw both his guard in the man out or just him? Oh, fuck. Alright, I definitely like the flamethrower so much.
The young man never told her that the Ura's native language is not to be used by foreigners. To do so is a terrible insult.
So he's a foreigner? Fuck you, plant. Yeah.
It was then that she decided to escape. The two of them could flee the city together and go to the Tassel terminals.
And we get to the song I like the best in this game so far.
I dig my hole, you build a wall.
They would hide inside a garbage
can
until it got ingested by a scumbag, then let him slosh on out of the city for disposal.
What? I was doing two, really? I want him to come up at the same time again. Okay. Oh god, I'm dead. I'm so gonna die! Can I kill one of them? Shit.
I dig my hole, you build a wall.
Come on. Damn it. There we go.
The plan almost succeeded, but the authorities were already there when that scumbag sidled up to the city walls.
Come on. Come here, birds. There we go.
The young man had sent the authorities a tip. Told him her father was using her to sell secrets to the Tassel terminals.
Man, that guy's a dick. Okay. Okay. I am seriously just dead because of these things. Seriously.
She and her father were arrested for treason, but her father got a deal. Return to work for the Mansers, and she'd go free.
Good God, I hate those, like, automatic, like, turd things. Plants.
Before they parted ways for the last time, her father whispered a desperate plea. Hurry home to the den and lock yourself in.
Okay. No, no. No. Holy shit! I was not expecting that thing to pop up at all. Can you die? Can you die yet? Can you die yet? Alright. Thing is over there.
She did as she was told. And deep down underground inside
oh,
that den,
I was not getting health.
She found a journal written in her father's hand.
I was not getting health. Oh, what the heck? Alright, I was not expecting to fight me. I did not expect multiples of me.
The next day, the door to the den turned to ash. The girl came up for air, and she saw the calamity all around her.
Okay. How did I survive that entire thing? That is what I want to know.
When the kid wakes up, his world still in pieces, just the way he left it.
Okay. I'm not gonna ask questions. I don't even know how to come back from that. If you guys enjoyed it, I guess, leave a like down below, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!